Hello friends, in today's video we are going to see examples of dynamic memory allocation. So first of all, what I will do? I will give you an example of array and a structure. Okay, and these are very important. So first of all, let's take an example of array. So what I am going to do here is, I will create an array which can store 10 elements and I will do it using dynamic memory allocation. So first of all, what I will do? Use malloc function to take memory. Okay, malloc 10 into size of int. And you may be thinking, why size of int? Because integer need not be always 4 byte. It is compiler and OS dependent. So there can be a situation in some OS and in some compiler it can be more than 4 byte or less than 4 byte. So be on the safer side, I am going to use size of int. So what this malloc will do? It will take a memory block of 40 byte from operating system and will give to us the starting address. Okay friends, and what did our next task? As we have been given a starting address, we need to store it in pointer. And what kind of pointer it will be? The kind of data that I am going to store in this particular block. And what will be the data type? Integer. So it is an integer pointer. So basically this PTR will be pointing to the starting address of this particular 40 byte block. Now let's see how I am going to use this 40 byte memory block as an integer array. So to do that, we have two techniques. One is directly using pointer dereferencing technique and another is array technique. Okay, now first see pointer dereferencing technique. So for that, what I am going to do? I am going to run a loop for int I smaller than 0, int I equal to 0, I smaller than 10, I plus plus, I am going to run a for loop. And this for loop, what I am going to do? I will update value first. And in next line, I am going to print the value. Printf percentage data space and then ptr plus I, and then I am going to dereference it. I will tell you what is this. Suppose this is our memory block and operating system has given us a memory block which is starting from memory address 100. Okay, so our first data will be stored from 100 to 103 and our next block will start from memory address 104 and our next block will start from memory address 108. And so on, 112, 116, 120 and so on. Okay, so in PTR there will be 100. Suppose this is our PTR pointer, 100 will be stored here. So what I am doing here is, in first iteration I will be equal to 0. So PTR plus I will be equal to PTR, that is 100 plus 0 into size of integer, as it is an integer pointer. And what is the size of integer? Let's assume it is 4. So 0 into 4, 100. So what it will do is, it will update the value here in first iteration, that is 0 into 0, it will update 0 here, and in next line it will print 0. Okay, What will happen in second iteration? In second iteration, I will be equal to 1. So, PTR plus I will be equal to 100 plus 1 into 4. That is 104. And what it will do? It will update at this location 1 into 1. That is 1. And in next line, it will print it. That is 1 will be printed. And what will happen at second iteration? In second iteration, I will be equal to 2. And what will be our PTR plus 2 will be equal to 100 plus 2 into 4. That is 100. So it will update the value here. And what it is going to update with? 2 into 2. That is 4. And in next line, it will print. That is, it will print 4. And similarly, in next few iterations, after few iterations, what is going to happen? This will be 9, it will be 60, here it will be 25, 36, 49, 64, and 81. And these things will be printed here. So this is how I am going to access this array using pointer arithmetic. Now, we have one more syntax which we can use here, which is array syntax. See how we are going to use it. Simple. PTR of I equal to I into I. Okay. And printf percentage data. And then PTR I. So this is how simple it is. You can use array syntax also here. Okay friends, one more thing friends. Here PTR of I is equivalent to PTR plus I dereferencing. As PTR is itself a pointer, that is array name is itself a pointer variable which is going to store the starting address of that particular array. Okay. Now let's see a structure. How we are going to deal with a structure? That is how we are going to allocate memory to a structure variable and then how we are going to use it. So now to do that, let's take an example of a structure which will be a node of a linked list which we are going to learn in future. Okay. So let's first define that structure. Struct node, it will have two part, int data or struct node star link. That is second part. So basically I am creating a data structure which will have two part. In one part, it is going to store an integer variable, and in second part, it is going to store an address. And state address of what? Another node which is like itself only. Okay? That is another node which will have integer in its first part and link in its second part. And this is known as self-referential structure. That is a structure which is going to store an address of node or element as itself. Okay friends, now let's see how we are going to allocate our memory and how we are going to access it. So to allocate memory, what we are going to use? Malloc. Okay. So, in malloc, if you remember, what are we going to pass? How many bytes of memory I want. But do we know how many bytes this node is going to require? No. So, what we are going to do? Size of struct node. Okay, friends? Then, what this malloc function will do is, it will take a memory block from memory, okay, and they will give us a starting address. And how big this memory block is going to be, it will vary from operating system to operating system, okay. But in my operating system and compiler, integer is a 4 byte and pointer address, this pointer will be of 8 bytes, so it will give 12 byte of memory block and a starting address of it. It gives a starting address, actually a starting address, and to store this at starting address I need a pointer. Let's name this pointer with T. And what is the type of this pointer? It is a type of a struct node, that is, it is going to store the address of a struct node. So what will happen now? So what will happen now is, this is our memory block, okay, 12 byte, and I am defining a T variable, sorry, it is a pointer. So T will point to the starting address of this particular block. Now let's see how we are going to access this block and access this block. So to access this block, I can use two type of syntax. One is pointer syntax and second thing is arrow operator. Now let's see how we can do it using pointer syntax. So suppose this is data part and this is link part. So to access data part, first of all I will dereference it, and this is my data. And suppose I want to dereference the link part, then star T dot link, that is T will store the starting address. It will first find out the starting address and then go from here to here and find out the integer. Then in second line it will do the same thing for the link part. And how to use this arrow operator? To do it using arrow operator, you just need pointer name and the part which you want to access. T arrow data for data part, T arrow link for link part. So you can see here how simple it is. And you can see here how many extra things are required. This bracket is required, star is required, dot is required. So using this arrow operator, we can remove all these. Okay. So this is how we are going to access a structure variables. So this is all I have for this video. And one more thing, we can do the same thing using calloc also. Okay. But calloc is only going to initialize it using zero. And one more thing I forgot. Suppose I have used this block. And I want to free it. So I will just use free T and it will free this memory block. Okay. And our compiler will let operating system know that I have used this 12 byte of memory. Now you can use it for your own purpose. Okay. So this is all I have for this video. And if you have liked for this video, then please like, share and subscribe. And thanks a lot for watching.